हेलो हेलो, एम आई ऑडिबल? हाँ, सो
यस सर।
के गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल। सो टुडे द एक्सपेरिमेंट इज ट्रांजिएंट रिस्पॉन्स एनालिसिस फॉर आरएल सर्किट। सो प्रीवियस एक्सपेरिमेंट ऑलरेडी वी हैव डिस्कस व्हाट इज द ट्रांजिएंट, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ ट्रांजिएंट फॉर द आरसी सर्किट एनालिसिस। And today, similar way, the similar instruments, similar equipment, DSOs and the signal generators and also the trainer kit. So similar experimental kit is there. So in this experiment, we have just checked the performance for the RL circuit. So RL circuit, we know that R, the simply we have to change the value of R and L and check the performance, means transient conditions. So already discuss about the transient conditions when there is a sudden change in load, or here the basically switch turn on and turn off. So when we just turn on and turn off, the you know the inductor property. So just behavior of this L, we have to check the performance behavior. So here again we have to simply apply the function generator by using function generator step input, DC step input, and so we have to check the performance of this circuit. So now again, the Saptarishi sir just explain about this experiment, and also we have just visualization through this simply DSO. We have to check the output performance and the input device, that is the signal generator. So Saptarishi sir, so now start this experiment.
Hello. Hello, am I audible
yes,
to all
sir.
Of you? Okay, one second. Hey, good afternoon to all of you. Today we will going to perform our next experiment, and that is transient response of RL circuit. Okay, transient response of RL circuit. Okay, so in the that is our circuit. You can clearly see this is our circuit. This is our experimental kit. Okay. In the experimental kit, you can clearly see resistance is here from starting 1 ohm to 10, 1 kilo ohm to 10 kilo ohm resistance. We have this kind of resistance, okay? And beside that resistance, three inductor is there. I think 1 millihenry to 10 millihenry. I think it is visible to all of you, okay? That is our experimental kit. So we just connect resistance and inductor in series, so that we can find out the transient response. We can see the transient response of this circuit. Okay. So in the input of the circuit, you can clearly see this is the function generator. This is the function generator which we will use as a input of the circuit. What is the purpose of the function generator? It is basically nothing but it is basically generate the input signal. Okay. So in the screen of the function generator, you can clearly see the signal input amplitude is 3 volt. I think you have clearly see, okay? And frequency is 400 hertz. We can manually increase this frequency and amplitude also, okay? So in the input of the circuit, we connect this function generator to generate the signal, step signal, okay? And this is the cord of the function generator, and it is the input terminal. It is the input terminal of the circuit. In the input, we connect the function generator. Okay, and also in the output, you can clearly see this is the DSO, the function generator DSO. What is the full form of DSO? What is the full form of DSO? Digital storage oscilloscope. So in the output of the RL circuit, we connect a DSO so that we can see the output signal. Okay. So that we can find out the transient response of the RL circuit. Okay. But also we have to connect. You can clearly see there are two channel is there. Okay. From the channel one, one crocodile cord is there. From the channel one, one cord is connected to the input, so that we can also see the input step signal in our DSO. Okay, from channel 1, we can clearly see input. From the channel 1, you can clearly see this is the input step signal, which we will generate through the function generator. Yellow color, okay. If I close the this is switch channel 1, then input signal, we can't see the input signal. When we on the channel 1, then we can clearly see the input signal of the function generator. This is the okay. And next the output in the channel 2, you can clearly see one channel 2 is also connected. In the channel 2, one crocodile jack is connected to the output of the signal. In the output of the signal, channel 2 is connected. You can clearly see channel 2 is connected. Okay. And output in the circuit, we connect the output terminal through the inductor. You can clearly see from double patch cord here, from double patch cord here in the inductor. So in the inductor, output we can find out from the inductor, okay, through the inductor. So in the screen, you can clearly see yellow color signal is the input signal and the blue color signal is the output signal. Okay, so if I increase it little bit, hello, am I audible to all of you? Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Okay. One second. Am I audible to all of you? Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So there are two channels there in the DSO. In the channel 1, which is yellow color indication, this is the input signal, okay, which is indicated in yellow color, and that is the output signal which is indicated in the blue color. Okay. So this is the blue color line is indicating the RL response of transient RL transient response of the circuit. Okay, so what is the graphs looks like? The graphs is similarly looks like this. You can see clearly, see this is the similar graph looks like this. Okay, in the graph you can clearly see the graph starts from the 9. Okay, it is graph that starts from the 9. Okay, after the few milliseconds, before 10 milliseconds, microsecond, the graph tends to transient, okay, steady state. Okay, this is the steady state line. Okay, that is the zero. You can clearly see this is the zero line. Okay, so graph starts from the 9, and after the few 10 microsecond, this is the 10 microsecond, 10 to 12 microsecond, it is reached to the steady state condition. Okay, that means zero condition. And after the some time, it will go to the negative, into the negative peak. Okay, it will go to the negative peak. Okay, and in the starting, it is starting from the plus 9, and when it is reached the negative peak, then it is also going to the minus 9.
okay, minus 9. Then after the few milliseconds, it is also going to the steady state condition. And that is represented in the graph. In the graph, you can also see it is starts from the some higher end, okay, higher position. After the few milliseconds, it is steady state. Okay, after some few milliseconds, it is going to the steady state. And after when is it is the positive peak. It is the positive peak. Okay, in the starting here, it is the positive peak. Okay. And after the few milliseconds, it is going to steady state. Okay, this is the steady state line. And after the steady state condition, it will again reach the negative point. Okay. Okay, after some time, it will again reach the negative point. If the positive point is plus 9, then after that steady state, it will go to the steady state condition. And after the steady state condition, it will reach the negative peak. And that is the same of the positive peak. Okay, and after the few milliseconds, it will go again to the steady state condition. Okay, and that is the RL response of the RL transient response of the circuit. Okay, transient response of the RL circuit. Okay, and in the circuit, you can clearly see we are using one 1 kilo ohm resistance here and 2 millihenry inductor we are using. Okay, you can also increase or decrease the value of the inductor. And also you can increase the value of the resistance as per your requirement. Okay. And in the input also we are giving 3 amplitude. Okay. Input signal, peak to peak voltage is 3 amplitude and the frequency is the 400 Hertz. You can also increase the Hertz frequency of the input signal and also increase the amplitude of the input signal. Okay. So here you can also vary change the value of the inductor, change the value of the resistance, change the value of the input signal frequency, change the value of the input signal amplitude, so that you can vary it according to your needs, and you can clearly see the graph in the DSO. Okay, that is the output graph. Okay. Hello, if you have any query, you can ask me. Hello.
Yes, sir.
If you have any query, then ask me. One thing I would like to say, that the graph is something look like that. But for this graph, we need to set the resistance from 200 to 300 ohm. But in the circuit, we have 1 kilo ohm resistance. For the 1 kilo ohm, for the mode value of the resistance, We cannot see the graph clearly in the screen. We see the smaller change, but we cannot see the graph clearly. Okay, the change is there. The positive peak and some positive peak is there. Graph is starting from this positive peak. After the positive peak, this is graph is going to in the steady state condition. A steady state condition means it is zero. The scale is zero, and after the steady state condition, it will reach the negative peak, and that difference and the positive peak and the negative peak are the equal value. Sirf positive peak is the in the positive, and negative peak is in the negative. Okay, if the positive peak starts from the plus 10, then after the some time it will reach the steady state, and after the steady state it will again reach the minus 10. Okay. And after some time, it will also go the steady state condition. And it is basically the transient response of RL circuit. If you have any query, then ask me. Hello.
Sir, if we change the input wavefront from one shape to different shape, then the graph is changed or not?
Okay, I will give to the mic to the sir, okay, and ask any question if you have.
Hello. So I think that this experiment is too similar to last experiment. So okay, if any query then ask me, otherwise I'm just okay. So how to write this write-up, your lab, just like lab copy, how to, so already discussed in the last classes, in one slide, I have discussed about the points, aim, objective, and the calculations, observation table. So all things are already in YouTube also, the video is available. So if you have any doubt, then last video, just watch last video, how to prepare your just write-up. So write-up is very important. So in theory, basically RL circuit, you just search in any book or Google, you just find out the RL theory, about the RL theory, how to find out for the RL series circuit, their transient condition. So time constant, everything is available. So that's, if you have any book of the network theory, any book, then also from that you get the all things, all basic theory. So in this practical, the basically, we have to observe the performance, observe their conditions. Means when we just given a one input, then what will happen? So what is the inductor property? We just see. So I think that all of you understood very well this experiment, no doubt. If any doubt, then ask me. Anyone?
Sir, if we change the input wavefront, then the graph is changed or not?
This graph is depends upon the input. If you supply, yes. If you have given other input, like a triangular or like a step input, means you know, a transient means sudden change in load, means switch on and off like that. Basically, when you connect any circuit and switch on and off, so that's why we have preferred the DC input signal, basically, with the step signals, mean practical behavior. Practically, you know, the practical behavior, basically, switch on and off. So switch on and off is basically shown by the step input signals. If you want to gradually increase or decrease, then you adjust, you apply ramp signal, means triangular signal, or like that. But the practical, basically practical, just for practical, we just apply the step input, like a switch on and off. So transient means basically on and off. So here we have to find out the what will happen in on and off. Just like that, open circuit, the inductor, we have a open circuit and just a short circuit and a steady state condition. So that's why we have here performed for the input signal is a step input. Hello. Any doubt? Saptarshi sir, if anyone to, you want to show anything from the slide?
No, sir.
So okay.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
So this is our experiment today. Transient response of RL circuit. We will upload the total class experiment video in the YouTube, and also we will provide this YouTube link to your Google Classroom, and you should complete your lab copy, okay, within the next week and upload it and scan it and upload it in the Google Classroom. And again, if you have any query, then you will ask in the Google Classroom, okay, and we will get back to you, okay. So that's it for today. Okay, if you have any query, then you will ask in the Google Classroom, and within the next week you can upload the lab copy in the A4 paper in the Google Classroom, okay. And also the format of the lab copy also SAR is given to you, okay. So format is there, okay. Thank you everyone. Thank you.